Hey, Guildmaster Kent here, and we have looked at a warrior. You can find it in this group, and we looked at the cleric. We're going to take a look today at another build in the class of a building, and we're going to see exactly what you want to build. If you want to build a warrior, you can find that list under this page and see what that is and what you need to buy. The next one that we're going to look at is mage powers, and mage is, in my opinion, the best one that you can buy. Because let me tell you, all right, when you buy this ability or these abilities, you damage the whole gate. Okay, so if you have the right general on, you will find that as you hit, you build up your power and your health as well. What I recommend as a mage is the first thing that you should buy is enrage, okay? Then the next thing you should buy is polymorph. Now, the reason I say that is because enrage will give you the ability to grow, okay, your power. As you hit with the enraged, it gives you 20% on your attack, and it helps build your strength. So each hit you hit with, you're doing more damage and you get stronger with enraged. Now, polymorph is used to help the lower characters in the guild that you're in, because what you do is you poly for them and they don't get damage when they hit that way. After you buy polymorph 1 and enrage, I would say that you should get at least 2. Then I recommend you buy confused, and that as you get higher, you are able to put confuse on the ones that are attacking your guild and be able to help against your guild, because when the other team hits, they take damage off themselves, which is really cool. Yeah, I like using it on other guilds, but I hate it on myself because I keep damaging myself. Now, there are other ones here, which is Fireball. Now, Fireball, it works that you damage the one above and the one below of the one you're attacking. So it does damage to three at once. But the problem with it doesn't build your strength. So you need to make sure that you're strong. Then the next one I recommend you buy is build on those three and have the highest level in those you can get before you buy any of the other abilities. And the next ability you should buy after you get those at the proper level, which the highest level you can buy in Polymorph is 3, and the highest level you can buy in Enraged is 5, and the highest level you can buy in Fireball is 6. Then I recommend you get Magic Barrier. Now, what this does, it is unique. It absorbs 100% damage in guild battles and guild monsters and lasts 1 hour on self only. So it's only good for yourself. But what it does, it's cool because at the higher levels, it's important that we have this because it takes away their ability to harm you. Okay? And it's really cool that it does that because at higher levels, if you're being attacked by a higher level, it takes you off, and it depends how their magic hits. And it's really helpful. And then the other one that I like, but the only way it works is really if you're being attacked by a low-level guild, then you can be able to fool them with Mirror Image. Now, what Mirror Image is, it targets an ally with this spell to assume their appearance, and you have 80% chance to dispel when debriefed. Okay, so when they go to attack you, you have a good chance of them not being able to do it to you, and it is kind of cool. It really works well with different abilities, and the higher levels you are, the more that you will find that it's good for. But it only works with low-level guilds because the higher-level guilds, you know, they have it, and you know, it really isn't any good, and it's a waste to buy. And I'd recommend that you buy it last. Now, as far as a general for mage, depending on your level, if you're level 300, you can get the best one that I find, which is Muse. But if you're at a low level and you're a mage, I don't. It's strongly recommended that if you're a low-level mage, you're not going to do much damage. If you're going to be a mage, I recommend that you work on your attack, your defense, and your health, and build up your ability in your runes because it's so important as a mage. The more damage you do, the more damage you do to them. And it is very important to your guild. You are one of the most important players in a guild battle. So it's important that we have the proper stats. And later on, You want to get the good generals, and I recommend that you take the time to get Vincent, because what Vincent does, and I have him on my mages, that as you hit, you gain health. So it's important as a mage that you're helping the guild to the best of your ability. And as I hit with my mages, I build up my health too, which helps the clerics or the healers, whichever you prefer, and builds that back up again. So it's very helpful. And I recommend that on all mages, you take the time to get Vincent and use him to your advantage, because at the higher levels, he does more health heal, and it's such a cool advantage. Okay, it really is. And as I said, the best mage or the best mage general that I find is in my opinion, and I'm only a humble opinion, that it's Muse. And now, if I take a look at my levels, I have both in my both generals in mine, and I have Muse as my main general, and I have Alexander as a backup general, because the higher levels that they are, the better off you're going to hit. Like my Muse is at level 22, and she does 16% damage to progressive ability, plus 27 damage and 13 damage on bonus ruins. So I'm hitting with this account, this my main accounts, I'm hitting with 30 plus damage on them. And I recommend that she's a balanced general, so you need to team her up with Crystalla. And my Crystalla is at level 31, and she has 210 defense when attacked, and 23 player defense, and 50 damage deflected, and 10% back on your opponent. So it is cool. And the other one I have in that lockup or the layout is where did he go? I just had him. Oh, come out, wherever you are. Okay. I'll go this way, because the three generals you want Muse as your main, then you want Alexander as your second. Okay. Sorry, Crystalla as your second, and the third you want in that alliance is Vanathan, okay? Because he is a balanced general as well, and he grants physical resistance ability. He does the same thing as Catherine, but at a balanced level or a blue. And you align him, and it's harder to hit because it's just the way it is. That's my wrap on Mage, and I hope that I help you. If you're looking for a guild, feel free to join us. If you're going to join us, you need to apply with your stats. I need your attack, your defense, and your health. And if I don't have that, you will not be included. We have a guild of 97, and come join us if you want. Thanks, that's my take on Mage.